Hello friends, today we will discuss about hydraulic pumps. Basically, pump is a device which is used to lift the water from low level to high level by converting the mechanical energy into hydraulic energy, thereby increasing the present energy of the liquid. Here we come to discuss about classification of pumps. Pumps are broadly classified into two types, partial displacement pump and rotodynamic pumps. In partial displacement pumps, the present energy of the liquid is increased by pushing or displacing the liquid with a moving member or a piston. The positive displacement pump examples are reciprocating pumps and rotary pumps. The rotary pumps like gear pump, screw pump, vane pump, etc. In rotodynamic pumps, the present energy of the liquid is increased due to the dynamic action of the rotating element, known as impeller. Present energy of the fluid increases due to the change in its angular momentum. And reciprocating pumps are further classified into according to the action of water on the piston. They are single acting pump and double acting pump. And according to the number of cylinders used, single cylinder pump, double cylinder pump, triple cylinder pump. According to the presence of air vessel, pump without air vessel and pump with air vessel. Construction and working principle of a single acting reciprocating pump. The main parts of the single acting reciprocating pumps are cylinder, piston with piston rod, connecting rod and crank mechanism, suction pipe with suction valve, delivery pipe with delivery valve. And working. Its working is in single acting reciprocating pump, the liquid enters one side of the piston only. The piston reciprocates inside of the cylinder as the crank rotates. The to and fro motion of the piston creates suction and compression inside the cylinder. Suction stroke. When the crank turns in clockwise direction from A to B, the piston moves from left to right and creating the vacuum in the left space of the cylinder. The vacuum causes suction of the liquid from sump to opening the inlet valve. The suction stroke is completed, then the crank reaches to B. And the discharge stroke. When the crank further turns from B to A, the piston moves towards left, increasing the pressure inside the cylinder. The high pressure inside the cylinder causes the suction valve to close and delivery valve to open. Therefore, the high pressure liquid flows out of the cylinder into the delivery pipe. The discharge stroke will be completed when the crank reaches the position A. In single acting reciprocating pump, the suction and delivery strokes are alternately carried out by pulsating output is obtained. Working of double acting pump. The double acting pump working is similar to single acting pump, but the water is entering both sides of the cylinder in double acting pump. Hence, the double acting pump required two suction pipes and two delivery pipes. In this pump, suction and delivery pipe strokes occur simultaneously when the piston moves right or left. Vacuum is created on the left side and high pressure builds up on the right side when it moves from towards the right. Therefore, the liquid enters the left portion of the cylinder, opening the suction valve S1, and there is a discharge of liquid from right side opening the discharge valve D2. Similarly, when the piston moves towards the left, there is suction through the valve S2 and delivery through the valve D1. There is a discharge from the double acting pump is more uniform than the single acting pump. Discharge and work done of a reciprocating pump. Let us talk about some useful terms. Let L is equal to length of the stroke and R is equal to radius of the crank, that means L by 2, and A equal to cross-sectional area of the piston, and N equal to number of the revolutions made by the crank per minute, and HS is the suction head and HD is the delivery head. H equal to total lift of the water, that means HS plus HD. Single acting pump. The weight of the liquid discharged per second equal to the specific weight of the liquid into discharge, that means W into Q. The work done per second or the theoretical power equal to the weight of the water discharged per second into the total height of the lift. That means WQ into HS plus HD. Double acting pump. In double acting pump, let D equal to diameter of the piston rod and A equal to cross section area of the piston. And A1 equal to cross section area of the cylinder on the rod side. Therefore, discharge equal to LAN by 60 plus LA1N by 60. Here, A is very small compared to area of the piston. Discharge Q equal to 2 LAN by 60. The work done per second or theoretical power equal to WQ HS plus HD. Here, the discharge in double acting pump is twice than the single acting pump slip. It is observed that the actual discharge supplied by the pump is less than the theoretical discharge. That means the difference between the theoretical and the actual discharge is called slip. In some cases, Q actual is greater than Q theoretical. That means the actual discharge is greater than the theoretical discharge. Then the slip is negative and hence it is called negative slip. Percentage of slip. Slip is often expressed in terms of percentage. Percentage of slip equal to Q theoretical minus Q actual by Q theoretical into 100.